And welcome back. These drinks can quench our thirst, make us feel refreshed, but some of them have a whole lot of sugar.
Oh, look at that.
Oh, sweet drinks taste good, but too much sugar can be bad for our health. It can be bad for our teeth. So today, how much is too much?
Dr. Roberto Monteagudo is back from the Wisconsin Smiles to talk about the damage sugar can do. Hey, good guys. To see you.
Good to see you. Happy Summerfest,
this
by the way.
This is horrible.
It's disheartening.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. It's crazy. Let's talk first before we get into these specific examples here, how tooth damage occurs. How is it happening in our mouth?
Well, it happens basically as we eat, you know, we break down certain nutrients within the food. In this case, we're talking about sugar. So what happens, all of us have bacteria in our mouths, and our bacteria really loves sugar. And so what happens basically is as you drink these, sugar will attach to your teeth, your bacteria then will start eating that sugar, and then it creates an acidic environment. Okay, so the byproduct is basically, it's plaque tartar, and it's acidic. So some of these beverages also have acid in them. So both of them are kind of battling against your enamel. And so it weakens your enamel, okay? And then now other bacteria can come in and cause cavities, especially between your teeth. I mean, if you're not flossing or anything like that, that's really where most of them start.
Hanging out.
If you're going to eat a sugary treat, some cake, a cookie, candy, one of these sugary drinks, if you're going to splurge, let's say, is the best idea to brush as soon after as you can?
Yeah, definitely. This is the thing. Some of these drinks are in my house.
Okay? Yeah.
And so, you know, I splurge from time to time too. But what I do is after I drink them, I go immediately and rinse my mouth out with water and or mouthwash.
Okay.
If I have a toothbrush and toothpaste, I'll go ahead and brush my teeth. So it's really, really important that, you could splurge, you could have some of these drinks, but rinse your mouth afterwards.
Okay.
Another big problem is, and the Wisconsin Dental Association had a really cool campaign. It was called Sip All Day, Get Decay. And so I'll ask some of my patients, for example, do you drink soda? Yeah, I only have one soda, but they drink it all day long.
Slowly throughout the day.
Yeah, and so they'll have some of these drinks, they'll drink it all day long, and so they maintain that acidic environment in their mouth. And they think it's only one a day, but really it's really causing a lot of damage,
It's doing a lot of damage in our body, in our mouths. I mean, so this sugar content example is mind-blowing. I think when you look at in one of these bottles that's behind these cups, I mean, you come down on this end and you see this entire thing is full of sugar, 75 grams.
Yeah. That looks like a Mountain Dew. And while we're not calling out any specific brands or whatever, but look at, you're drinking a cup of sugar, 18. Is it tablespoons
teaspoons. It's 18 teaspoons of sugar. And this is what's on their label. So if you go online, there's multiple places online we could actually go and kind of calculate based on the sugar content how many tablespoons or teaspoons of sugar are in your drink.
77 grams.
Yeah.
That's a ton.
And that is
gross. Look at this root beer. I love root beer. I think it's delicious. I always thought it was like for dark colas.
Yeah.
I always thought
And
it
you
was
think you're not doing the caffeine, so you're doing a little better. Nope, you're not.
Look at that.
Right there.
But even as we move down the line, other sodas, this is vitamin. This is a vitamin type water.
It's
supposed to be healthy. And look at how much sugar is in that right here. That's unbelievable. You're drinking, so if you drink that cup, it's like a fourth of it
is sugar. Try and chomp on that, right?
Energy drinks, Gatorade. This is something I give my son for when he has a game of some sort. And there's quite a bit of sugar even in a sport drink. Look at that.
Yeah, so the thing
even juices.
Is,
you think about that's what you give to the kids.
Yeah, exactly. And some of this, for example, and it's crazy because some of these, I went shopping the other day at one of the Pick and Saves around our house, and there was one that said no sugar. I mean, it's advertising no sugar. You turn the label around.
Yeah,
and it had like 50 grams of sugar inside of it.
Because they say no sugar added right?
Added,
but it's like, but all that sugar is still in it, and it might be something like this, you know?
Exactly.
It's crazy. So what do we do? Are there other tips to kind of fighting the erosion, to making sure that we're keeping our mouths healthy?
Yeah, well, one of the things, again, limit your intake of these type of beverages, okay? There are
and slam them if you do.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, another thing, another little tidbit, drink through a straw so it doesn't hit your teeth. But
you get the mouth lines, doctor.
Yeah.
You get the wrinkles then.
Okay. but again, you know, limit your intake, brush and floss, okay? We've talked about this in previous shows. Make sure you see your dentist at least every 6 months.
Yeah.
You know, you could brush and floss as much as you want, but if you're taking, you're taking these beverages on a daily basis, okay, and a lot of it, then it doesn't matter what you do,
right?
You can still have problems.
You need that professional cleaning.
Yeah.
I love getting my teeth cleaned.
And we're not only talking about this. I mean, I was actually going to bring, there's also a segment on certain candy bars and candy,
yeah,
how much sugar they have.
And they really stick to
And they stick to your teeth, exactly. Yeah, yeah, exactly.
I like the sweets, you know, like the Starburst and the taffies, yeah, the things that really get stuck.
I'm a Baby Ruth fan, so.
Yeah, yeah. So I'm coming in every 6 months. Feels so good.
Right now you have a special offer for the first 25 callers. You are going to receive a free oral health screening session that's a value of $125. If you're one of the first 25 to call this phone number right now, it's 414-982-3676 for that free offer. Mention the morning blend. You can visit WisconsinSmiles.com. And just quickly, at what age should you bring a kid to see the dentist?
Usually between 18 months to 2 years, actually. Even for their first visit. Sometimes these kids come in, they don't want to sit in the chair. So even just to get them acclimated
to the
environment.
Going to
the office. And so it's a really good way to start.
Great to see you.
You're welcome.
Great to see you.
Thank
you. A little depressing with all this.
Can do it.
Good stuff. Thank you.
Sorry about that.
All right.